Very good morning, students. Once again, I welcome you all for the digital classroom of Science and Technology Part B. Dear students, as I had already told you that this is the last lesson of your 10th standard syllabus, lesson number 9, Social Health. We had already finished with the explanation of the lesson, and today we are going to start with the textual exercise. I hope that you are ready with the answers of the textual questions. So let's start with the question answers of lesson number 9. Question number 1. It is fill in the blanks with appropriate word. First one is, laughter club is a remedy to drive away dash. Yes? Yes, students, laughter club is a remedy to drive away mental stress. Then second one is, alcohol consumption mainly affects dash system. Which system is affected? It is the nervous system. Third one is, the act dash is to curb the cyber crimes. Which is that act? It is IT Act 2000. So these are the answers of fill in the blanks. Second one is, answer the following. First one is, which factors affect the social health? Now you have to write in detail about the different factors which affect the social health. I had only given you the points and or headings, and you have to elaborate all these points in your own word. Like the first one is good amenities for people. Now, in order to maintain the social health, there should be good amenities like food, water, shelter, clothing, then medicinal help, and opportunities, equal opportunities for education. Then surroundings should be clean, transport facilities should be properly provided. Okay, so all these you will explain in your own words. Second factor is social and political conditions of surrounding. Now it should be observed that the connection with the criminals should not be there, and if at all such criminal ties are there, then it can affect the social health of the human beings up to a large extent or a greater extent. Then third is gardens, playgrounds, empty plots for outdoor games, sports clubs, etc. Now here you have to write what are the importance of gardens, playgrounds, empty plots for outdoor games and sports clubs, etc. Right? Like garden, they are for, first thing is gardens are to spend your leisure time to get some fresh air. Then playgrounds for the young generation to play around, outdoor games. Then empty plots should be there for games like football, hockey, cricket, and the sports club also should be there. All this results into the personality development, and this makes the people strong and healthy. Fourth one is large number of friends and relatives, trust in others, respect and acceptance. So if you have a large number of friends and relatives, then you will never feel the loneliness. And when you have the trust or the faith in your peer group, in your friend circle, when you have trust in others, when you have respect for others, then definitely your social health is going to be very, very good. So all these points, all these headings, you have to elaborate and write. Second one is, which changes occur in persons continuously using internet and mobile phones? Here also I have given you the important points, and you have to elaborate them. Like the first one is, physical problems, tiredness, headache, insomnia, forgetfulness, joint pains, etc. Second one, in young children, penetration of radiation in bones because of the internet rays and mobile phones, then solitary and no harmonious relations. And the next one is the person becomes self-centered, selfish, and loss of sensitivity. And fifth one is no social responsibility. Okay, because such people who become self-centered and selfish, they lose the sensitivity towards other people, and these people, they never take any social responsibility, and thus their social health is disturbed. Third one is, which problems do the common man faces due to incidences of cyber crime? Now here also I had given you important points, and this actually you can write a lot about this if at all you are listening to the news, if at all you are reading the newspapers, if you are aware of the surroundings around you. As you know that misuse or cloning of Aadhaar, PAN card, credit card, debit card, so many crimes are conducted, okay. Then withdrawal of money from bank accounts through information leaked on fake or fraud calls. You know, at times you get fraud calls that you have got a prize of so and so amount. So you have to transfer a very minimal amount to this account number, and then you will get this huge prize amount, right? So that is all fake and fraud calls. We should never respond to them. We should never disclose our PIN or the mobile number or the other important numbers to anyone. Then online cheating, it is so very common. When you do shopping online, at times it happens that they show very good product, but when the product is delivered, it is not of that quality. Then financially and emotionally exploited on social media. You know, the people, they troll the others, and thus you know, they are emotionally and financially exploited, because you know, social media is, people are very, very active on the social media nowadays. Misuse of electronic media. Now, as you know that electronic media, it is very easy to use for sending vulgar messages, obscene pictures, and all such things. And hackers, this is through the internet, the hackers can send the virus to crush someone's laptop or computer, and then the people, they become victim of the cyber crime. Fourth one is, explain the importance of good communication with others. Okay, now here also I had given you the points. Now what are the explain the importance of good communication with others. So first point is, fierce competition and insecurity and criminal tendencies are developed. Then mental and emotional stress is developed to the human being, okay, if the atmosphere is such. Then the depression and frustration leading to addictions, suicidal thoughts, all these are also due to the you can say bad communication. So there should always be a very good communication with your family, with your friends, with your parents, with your counselor at times, okay. So this this creates a harmonious relations and in the family. Okay, they can give you the moral support, they give you of course the physical support, financial support, social support. So this all depends upon the good communication with others. Next is, see, question number 3, students, it is solve the following crossword that I have taken after the fourth question, because it needs a full chart and here the space is less. So first we'll do the fourth question, which are various ways to minimize stress. Now there are so many ways to minimize the stress. Like the laughter clubs are there. This has become very, very common, specifically in the lockdown period, right? People, they gather together and they laugh loudly, and thus the stress is reduced. Good communication. Just now I explained the importance of good communication. Then third one is writing. When you start writing, your thoughts, your expressions, your emotions, they are relieved. And at times we analyze about our mistakes also, and thus writing also reduces the stress. Then next is hobbies. If you have photography or gardening or cooking or reading good books, listening to the music, or working in your garden, or dancing, or drawing, or rangoli making, whatever it is. If you are having hobbies, then definitely it's a very good, you know, outlet to minimize your stress. Outdoor games and physical exercise. These are, of course, good to minimize stress, as well as they develop your body, right? You become healthy when you play outdoor games and when you do the physical exercise. Okay, so these are all the various ways to minimize mental stress. Now let's come back to question number 3. Solve the following crossword. Now the first one is continuous consumption of alcoholic and tobacco materials. What is that? Yes, where is the first one? It is addiction. 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 Second one is, this app may cause the cyber crimes. The second one is, yes, it is Facebook. FACEBOOK. It is vertical Facebook. Okay. The third one is a remedy to resolve stress. Just now we had seen the different factors, or different ways, sorry, which are used to minimize stress. So one is given there in the crossword. You have to find out. So that is the third one. It is reading. READING. It is also vertical. Then fourth one is requirement for stress free life. What is that? That is good food. It is also vertical. GOODFOOD. Good food. Next is various factors affect dash health. Which health? It is mental health. So various factors affect mental health. It is also vertical. MENTAL. Sixth one is art of preparing food items, and that is cooking. Okay, COOKING. So this is question number 3 crossword. Okay, and the answers I have given to you. Now next is question number 5. Give 3 examples of each. You have to write 3 examples of each. The very first one is hobbies to reduce stress. Okay, just now I had explained you to reduce the stress, the different ways, and one I had given you about hobbies. So you can write any 3 hobbies which you feel are can be used to reduce the stress. Gardening, drawing, painting, cooking, reading, making rangoli. Okay, all these are the different examples of different hobbies. You can have any hobby, stamp collection, okay, leaves collection, flower collection, right? These are all the different hobbies. Then second one is diseases endangering the social health. They are AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, that is the AIDS. And it is spread by HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. Okay, TB, tuberculosis, mental disorders, leprosy and cancer. These are the different diseases which are dangerous to the social health. Third one is physical problems arising due to excessive use of mobile phones. This has increased a lot during the lockdown because the students are using the phones, mobile, laptop, PCs for a very longer period of time. Even some of the parents or employees, they are also using the phone or laptop for a longer period of time, which leads to the different physical problems. And what are these problems? It is tiredness, headache, joint pain, insomnia. They can develop the cervical spondylitis, okay, backache, backbone problem. These are all the different diseases, or you can say the physical problems, which arise due to the continuous use of the mobile phones. Then the next one is activities under the jurisdiction of cyber crime laws. So which are the activities which fall under the jurisdiction of cyber crime laws? It is bank transactions by procuring PIN number. Okay, as I told you earlier that at times, you know, you receive a call from I am speaking from so and so company and you have got a prize of so and so and we have to transfer the amount in your account, so please give your PIN number. Never you should give your PIN number, important passwords and all on the mobile phone or on the call, because they are all fraud. And within a fraction of second, the money from the accounts are withdrawn by them. Okay. Misuse of written material or illegal sale of same. Hacking the information of government institutes and companies, etc. Okay. Then, the next question is, question number 6. What will you do and why? Now, in such questions, student, you have to write your own personal opinion. And believe me, if your answer is relevant to the question, you can definitely get full marks in this question, because there is no fixed answer for such types of question. You may feel one remedy, the other person may feel other remedy. You may feel that going to the doctor is important, the other may feel that no, we should give the time to our body so that it heals naturally, right? So these are all personal opinions. But when you are giving your personal opinion, you should know why. Okay, why is very, very important. Now, the very first one is, what will you do? Why? You are spending more time in internet, mobile games, phone, etc. So, what you will do? What you should do? Yes. Now, first is, you should know the importance of time. The time once gone never returns. Right? So, during your student life, you all are students, so you should spend your time for studies, some outdoor games, if you have some hobbies, some entertainment when you are free and you have finished with your studies and the written homework. You can also help your parents in the house chores, right? You can help them bringing the groceries or fruits or vegetables from the market. Good. Then, you should not play games or be on the social media for a longer period of time, because if you are using your mobile phone for a longer period of time, then slowly it becomes an addiction. Okay, so we should be very, very careful when we are watching anything on the mobile game, because if at all you get addicted to such things, it becomes very, very difficult for you to go away from them. Second one is, child of your neighbor is addicted to tobacco chewing. Okay, now here you may differ in opinion from others, right? You can explain first to the child, and then if the child doesn't understand, you can bring it to the child's parents' notice. You can explain the child the adverse effects of eating tobacco, right? Like it affects your mouth, it leads to oral cancer, right? Then if still the child is not listening and not understanding, then he should be taken to the counselor. Okay. Third one is, your sister has become incommunicative. She prefers to remain alone. This question was asked last year in the board exam. So what will you do? So it totally depends upon her. You should talk to her. You should take her outside. You should play some games with her, indoor games, or you can take her outside. You can ask your parents, your relatives, your friends to communicate with her so that she can openly speak about her stress, about her problems. It is completely your personal opinion. Okay. The next one is, you have to use free space around your home for good purpose. Okay. You can make a small garden, then you can plant some seeds or small saplings in there, and or you can use it for the outdoor games. You can use it for just walking or playing or calling your friends and enjoying any outdoor game with them. The next one is, your friend has developed the hobby of snapping selfies. Now here you should explain to your friend that continuously taking the selfies is not good. The person becomes self-centered, okay, and he should be diverted, he should be motivated to develop some other hobbies, right? Because if it becomes an addiction, it becomes a very bad habit, and at times it may lead to very severe results or at time accidents also. Okay. And the last one is, your brother studying in 12th has developed the stress. Okay. Now, as we know that 10th and 12th standard, the syllabus is very far, very vast. The students, they don't take the study seriously in the beginning, and then when the exam are near, they develop tension, they develop stress, right? They may go to depression. So what you will do to help your brother to lessen the stress? Okay. Then question number 7 is, what type of changes occur in a home having chronically ill old person? How will you help to maintain good atmosphere? Yes. Now here also you have to write your own opinion, or if at all you may have gone under this experience, ki somebody, your grandparent or your parent or your relative or anyone who is very, very severely ill, then how you can, you know, motivate them, how you can help them in maintaining good atmosphere at home. Now, again, I had given you the points and you can elaborate on these points. You have to make them tension free. You should help them to have a healthy diet and medicine. Okay. And each and every member in the family should equally contribute and cooperate for the betterment of the person. Okay. So now students, we had finished with the last lesson of the syllabus, and please complete your notebooks and please start with the revision, because you are having your prelim exams in the month of January. And students, please, please improve the handwriting and try to increase the speed of your handwriting, because we know, we understand that in last 1.5 years you have lost the, you know, the writing speed, because everything was online. Even we had the exams online. So please, please students, For science and social studies and all other subjects, it's okay. But for languages, you have to increase the speed of your handwriting, because language papers are quite lengthy and they are 3 hours paper, and you have to write a lot if at all you want to score good marks in the board exam. So students, please complete your books and start preparing for your preliminary examinations. Thank you. Take care of yourself and your family, students. Thank you.